Okay, so sometimes, like this tulip, do you see this tulip? You don't see any calyx, do you? Like down here, there's no calyx, no? So, there are some flowers that have directly only the petal-looking structure, no? Only this pink-looking structure without the calyx. This is the calyx, then this is the corolla, right? Then your androecium, and then your gynoecium and androecium, no? Like this is your normal flower. But like here, this tulip, we do not see any calyx, no, any petal, okay? So that type of flower, we will say that, okay, let me draw. This is a calyx, no? These are the corollas, okay? Let's say these are the corolla, okay? But what if the calyx and corolla, they fuse together? Okay, maybe during evolution, we don't know. What if the calyx and the corolla, they fuse together? They fuse together to give equal to a word known as perianth. Okay, so maybe you have heard this word, maybe you have not. Let me write. If you plus a calyx and you plus with a corolla, okay, if they fuse together, we will use the term perianth, okay? So just like this tulip, we will not say that this is a petal or a sepal, we will say it is a perianth, okay? So this is a perianth, that is clear, perianth. Now, if this perianth, you cannot differentiate between whether which part is the green and which part is the colorful part, we will say that it is non-differentiated perianth and it is homochlamydious. Okay. Now, here, you see, no, this one, it looks like a stalk, doesn't it? But it's not a stalk. This is your calyx. Okay. This is your corolla. And when they fuse together, they become, okay, they are fused together, they become the perianth, okay? Because usually, if it was a calyx, this is corolla, the calyx should have been like that, no? But here, it's like a tube, in one tube. There's no start, there's no finish. But you can see that this part is green, this part is color. What about tulip? There's no half green, no half color. So, if you can differentiate by looking at it, that from the perianth, the lower part must be the calyx, upper part must be corolla, then it will be hetero, okay, heterochlamydious flower, okay. Homochlamydious means you cannot see, okay, whether it's color or no color, which is calyx or corolla, we don't know. We hardly can see, we just say that it is homochlamydious. If we can see which one is which, it is heterochlamydious. Okay, next, this I think you all know, if all the four worlds are present, if the calyx is present, if the corolla is present, if the gynoecium is present, androecium is present, all the four are present, means it is a complete flower. But like here, you see only the calyx and the corolla, and you see only the male, okay, one male androecium, and there's no female, that is incomplete flower. So this is a unisexual or bisexual flower. You answer that in your mind. And the other one here is only the female one is present. The male are absent. So this is an incomplete flower. So if any part is absent, if the calyx is absent, also is incomplete. If the corolla is absent, also incomplete. If androecium only absent, also incomplete. Gynoecium only absent, also incomplete. Sometimes both of these will be missing, calyx and corolla. Sometimes corolla and androecium are missing, or sometimes calyx and gynoecium are missing. So anything can be missing, okay? Sometimes some flower you'll find only one petal and one male plant. Yes, these do exist. So that is a incomplete flower, okay? So any part can be missing. Sometimes only one female is there, gynoecium, and then petal is there and sepal is there, okay? Petals and sepal is there. So this is also incomplete, all right? Sometime only petal and sepal is there. There's no male, no female. So this is also an incomplete flower. Okay, now the term You must have heard, I'm not sure, but it's better that I refresh so that your concept is good. If, okay, the terms epigynous, hypogynous, and perigynous, we will see, okay, what they mean. So, this means we are talking, when you see the word gynous, means we'll be talking about the female part, the gynae, okay? Like, the gynosium, no, the gynosium means the female. So, if it's the gynae, we're talking about the female part. So, if the arrangement of the other parts of the flower are above the female, okay, see here, see this diagram. See this, they have cut, no? They have cut the TS. Sorry, my girls. It is LS, okay? They cut the LS. So, this is the ovary, okay? This is the, it's like this, okay? So, this is the ovary and here are the seeds, no? The ovules, okay? Here, these are the ovules. And then, this is the corolla. That's the calyx. This one is the calyx. This white one is the calyx. Then, not half, sorry. It's above. This is the calyx. Then the pink one you see is the corollas, no? Then you see the yellow ones, these are the androecium. So if all the other parts of the flower, that is all the four worlds, the three worlds, you have your calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. If these are all above the gynoecium, it is epigynous, means that they are sitting on top of the female, okay? Everyone is sitting on top of the mother, okay? Then it is epigynous, which means that the ovary is inferior to all the other parts, okay? Means of the position, doesn't mean girls are inferior, I mean position-wise, no? The ovary is below, okay? Below the other parts of the flower. So, it means that the ovary is inferior, or the word epigynous. Okay. Now look here in the down diagram. You are seeing this, let's say, is the gynoecium. Then here, this is the calyx. Then the corolla. Then the androecium. If they are all below. Okay. Here, like here, this one. The gynoecium is on top. Okay. So if, I think this image is better. This one. Yes. You can see this ovule, this one. This one is on top of the calyx, on top of the corolla, on top of the androecium. Okay. If the female is sitting on top of all the other worlds, then it is superior ovary or hypogynous. Okay. Superior means hypogynous. Okay. But what if it's in between, half? Half inferior, half superior means somewhere halfway. Like in these images, no? The calyx is down. The calyx is down. Here the calyx and corolla are down. But it is midway, okay? Like here, this is half, okay? So some parts is up, some parts is down. So it's half inferior, half superior, okay? So let's say the word semi, okay? Please don't say this. Miss said semi. This is, I'm just trying to make you understand. The word semi, no, means half, right? Semi-final. Not the final. It's a before the final, semi-final. So in between the final and the prelims, okay? Semi-final, let's say. So from the word semi, no, I'm just asking you to correlate. Doesn't mean you'll tell, oh, Miss said is semi, means is semi-gynous. No, it's peri only. But just try to correlate the word semi and peri, okay? So means like semi-final, no? Peri, okay? Semi-peri. So like it is half in between superior and inferior. It's in between. So when they arise from the rim, okay, of the cup of the ovary, okay? Like if this is the ovary, no? They arise from here, okay? The other floral parts, they're arriving halfway like this. This is the calyx, this corolla, this androecium. No? If they are rising half, means it is perigynous. Okay? So, if I use the word hypo, means ovary is dash. If I say the word epi, ovary is dash. And peri, ovary is dash. So, you try to remember. Okay?